here in Hlukhiv, which is about 10 kilometers from the Russian border, about 3 or 4 hours drive from Kiev, and it's quite a small town, isn't it? So,
oh God, it's not a small town. It was the capital of of Ukraine at the time of the Cossack. Mm.
So, what brings you here?
What brings me here? What brought me here? This is the town of my family. It's not only the town where four hetmans of Ukraine have been ruled, Leva Berezhnya Ukraina, which is left bank Ukraine. Were hetman Skarapatsky, Polibutok, Apostol, Razumovsky. And after the hetmanate, here was the college. It was called at the time Malarosian College. And Katerina II thought in 1763 that if she could liquidate the hetmanate and give the power to Malarosian College, she would no longer hear about Ukraine. It would be already Malarosia, and that's it. And she had to liquidate this college less than 20 years later, in 1782, because in this college, where she thought everything would be pro-Russian, came intellectuals, came jurists, came professors, and they ended up with the creation of the idea, the project of a Ukrainian autonomy. So she was very furious, and she had to liquidate the college. So here in Hlukhiv was born the idea of Ukrainian independence. It's for me very important. But also after that, in 1819, here, not far from Hlukhiv, a few kilometers from Hlukhiv, was born my great-great-grandfather, Nikola Tereshchenko. My great-grandfather was Ivan Nikolovich, near Nikolaevich. So it to show that here, the Ukrainian feeling is very strong, very strong. You could see here in the, during the holidays, the city is fully blue and white and blue and yellow,
yes.
and people are with Vyshevankas, and they speak Ukrainian with pleasure. So the city is vibrantly patriotic. Unfortunately, the power is still pro-Russian. It's still a party of region. Now it's named Volya Naroda, but people are very conservative and very pro-Russian. And also they have a tendency to steal everything. So for 18 years, they basically ruled the place, and the city now is very poor. Everything is dying.
Yeah. And with the industry as well, there's a number of industries that have closed down. So do you hope to change this?
Well, you asked me why I'm decided to come here. Well, when I came here for the first time in 2002, I started to invest. Well, the house of my family is now Institute of Lubyanic Culture. It's an institute of vast crop. It is Lyon, it is flax and hemp. No, to make the fiber, the plants. It was very successful. Now we are selling our fiber, hemp and flax fiber, to the whole world, to China, France, Poland. And I could see that it's not so difficult, that people are very educated, they like to work. I could see that the nature is plentiful, is giving us very good raw material. And Ukraine is very close to the markets, because all the we're selling flax, for example, for the car industry, and all the car makers are around Ukraine. So we have all the ingredients for success. The only thing is we have to have a clean country, clean from corruption, so investors could invest. Because I'm asking myself, why investors are not investing? I did it. I'm not so rich, but it was very successful. Why is nobody else doing it? And there are two reasons. The first one, we have to clean the country for corruption. So investors can believe that everything will be fine, that the judge will give a normally
Honest opinion.
Will give an honest opinion, will rule by the law. And the second condition, the reason for there is no investor is the previous power, the previous vlast. It was better for them that the people were poor and without work, so they could buy everything very cheap. including the election. So there was two reasons for the investor not to come.
Yeah.
And I think that I can change all this, and the investors will come.
Yeah.
Also, I hope from the United States and Canada.
So if you have your successful business here, then is that why you moved into politics? Or what was the reason?
Not at all.
I never. Do you have big ambitions in Ukrainian politics?
No, not at all. Not at all. My grandparents, grandparents, mm-hmm. For example, Nikola Tereshchenko was born here in 1819, was mayor of the city for 22 years, and he did a lot of good. Before him, his father, Artemy, was burgmaster of the city for 5 years. So it's the city that they have built, and all the buildings that they have built are still there, with 10 buildings, which is a pedagogical university, two schools, two hospitals, one cathedral, one bank, their residence, which is now Institute of Lubyanic Culture, also the Agrotech College. So all those buildings are still there. They still serve the people. So people had a good opinion of my family.
Yeah.
And they saw that I was investing my money and everything officially, everything clean. We never paid any bribes. I mean, everybody knows it in the city because they don't even ask anymore. So they see that it's possible to do it. So on the last election for mayor, there was only one candidate from party of region.
Yes.
And all the other candidates were eliminated for technical reasons or physical reasons,
yeah.
Which basically means there was no choice. Nobody was willing to try.
I read as well that with your campaign for the town as well, you didn't have any advertising. I read in an interview that you actually went from door to door effectively.
Yeah, it was very strange. When I asked for billboards, they were the same thing. They said, I cannot have one. So they sent a lot of black PR. They did a very dirty campaign, a lot of black PR, not any respect of democratical principle. Mm-hmm. So we went to the street and we talked to the people. And for me, it's a very big surprise because I saw that being a European and talking about progress and places to work, I will be more appealing to the youth. I mean, the young people that will be more, I believe, supporting me than the old people. Mm-hmm. The old people could have been a little bit more pro-Russian or maybe the old style, they will be opposed to take off the statue of Lenin here in the city, because I always said I will do it, so maybe the old people will not support me. Mm-hmm. And when I started to go in the markets, to go in the street, to meet the people, I have always around me, I saw that always around me was an army of babushke.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And not every mayoral candidate has that. I mean.
No, I mean, it was not absolutely not expected, but everywhere. And they were like my safety cordon.
Yeah, they're like your security.
Security. They knew who would be the provocators because they knew everybody so they immediately cleaned the place away. Mm-hmm. They were supporting me very strongly when I had the contestation. They were absolutely fierce and strong-headed. So. And during the vote, I understand that those babushki, which unas class,
the old ladies.
Babushki unas, they took all their friends, all their neighbors, all their families, and they went to vote, which is very, very new because in Hlukhiv, usually old people are very passive.
Yeah.
And this time they were very active. U mnie is uragan babushok. A lot of babushki.
So you had queues outside.
Well, I always say that I went to the election for three things, clean the city of corruption, reanimate production, because here we have a lot of plants that are just
potential, but
even our clips of wood, even our bakery is not working here. I mean, it's crazy. And bring new working places, it means bring investors.
Yeah. Do you think that'll be easy? Because
it will be easy because
Ukraine is sort of sandwiched between Russia in the east and you have Europe.
I'm myself an investor, okay, and I know a lot of French investors, for example, or an American investor.
Invest in Ukraine?
You have to be crazy not to invest in Ukraine, because if you're normally constituted, if you're a normal investor, where is the labor force more skilled and the less expensive? Ukraine. Where is the nature the more plentiful? Ukraine. Where are the markets closer? What countries are the markets closer to the production base? Ukraine. Mm-hmm. So you have to be absolutely crazy today not to invest in Ukraine. you could, maybe you don't do it for the reason I told you, because you're afraid of corruption, but here there will be no more, or because you're afraid of the war. But here, I mean, this part of Ukraine, I mean...
You're far away, aren't you? It must be a few hundred kilometers away.
Yeah, it's far away, and also we have to protect our borders. We have to, because we have a border with Russia, and we know that Russia is a turbulent neighbor. So so we have to show dedication. We have to close our border. We have to make it strong and to welcome Russian tourists, but not Russian aggressors.
Michel Tereshchenko, thank you very much.
Thank you.